I think we are approaching a horizon that within the next 7 years, by 2025, it'll be hard for you to tell if you pass somebody in the hallway, if it happens to be a human or an android. Look, Turing had asked this 7 decades ago he had asked this. He started his thesis by saying, I propose for you to consider the question, can machines think? The whole purpose of artificial intelligence is that man may spend more time à la plage, at the beach. Are you today not enslaved? Are you not shackled today? How much amount of your time do you spend in creative thinking? You only spend barely 20% of your time in creative thinking. Now, what if you were to be liberated? What if you were to be having all of that just taken care of? What if machines were to come along and say, we'll take care of all of that stuff so that you can just be free to engage in creative expression? You know, singularity is the horizon that people estimate. By 2030, machines would have become more intelligent than humans. That's the horizon of singularity. I don't know about the more intelligent part, actually, I'll tell you, because intelligence is very differently defined. Intelligence is, to me, is creative. I can write a program to beat you in chess. You may be super smart, and I could be a dumb machine. I'll beat you in chess. How? It's only 8x8. I will explode all the spaces, and then I will say, each one of the places, I will give it a rating. And then I will just select blindly, okay, this is the most advantageous rating for me, so I'll move this here. I ask you, is that smart? That's brute force. Do you think such thinking can cure cancer? We have to be the driver. We have to steer these machines so that they can be the best friends that take care of all these common chores for us.